Take me outside, sit in the green garden. Nobody out there, but it's okay now. Bathe in the sunlight.
The leap into artist management was completely non-scripted. So it was something that happened really naturally, because a lot of the time the artists that were in the studio would ask questions, say, about the music they were doing, about the songs they were doing, about what other songs they should be doing. And after a while, I guess the questions kept coming until somebody sort of said, oh, do you think you can manage me? And first of all, I sort of reluctantly did it. And then I thought, right, I'm going to really try with one act. And I tried with this one act. And I got her signed to Blue Note in the States, but she was the youngest ever signing. To be honest, I didn't really have much of a choice. As soon as I started doing it, more people sort of started to come my way. And it's kind of just led to here. I just think with some things that you have an affinity for, if it falls onto your lap and you deal with it, and I guess by dealing with it, it's almost like a signal to other people that, oh, he can do that. So then you do it. And then you become known for it. Running live events is not easy. There's a different energy almost that goes with it. It's a lot more sort of frantic. And on the day, you have to be like a swan. I always say, just the head above the water is calm, and underneath you're paddling like a crazy nut. Would I say live events are easy? I wouldn't say they're easy. I think having the right team is absolutely essential. That's what's going to make your life bearable within it. They're very gratifying doing live events, because you can see immediately that it's worked. But then we've evolved, the seminar has evolved in 1997, 2007, and that, I mean, we were close to 20 years of doing seminars. So it's kind of one of those things where if you don't know how to do it now, then you'll never know. So we know how to do them. We understand that format because we invented that format. Not to say that other people don't have their own formats, they do, but our particular edutainment format, we're kind of the only people that do that in that way. The different ways that a person can work within music, other than being an artist straight. You can be a tour manager. You can be an accountant. You can be an A&R person, it's artist and repertoire, the person that goes out and finds the talent. You can become a producer. You can be a mix engineer. You can be a cameraman. You can be all of these things. I always say it's kind of really weird, the music business. It's like, if you have a passion, but you are good at something that is attached to music, actually, even your own personal taste in music could see you work in a particular area of music for a long time. You can be an agent, you can be a promoter, you can be, there is a massive list of jobs that are associated with the industry. And then there are new growth areas, obviously online is massive. Right now, if you are an online marketing person, you'll probably be inundated. If you are really, really good at servicing music, either to blogs directly, or that you have your own blog that you are building as a brand. There is more of everything. I always say to acts now, you're not just, It's not as though you are competing with just the people around you, as in your the people around, peers, whatever, around you. It's none of that. You're actually competing with your immediate group, the people that are around you, and yesteryear's stars. Because all of those people now, they're online, they're available to be streamed, they're on iTunes, whatever. So if you come out as a band and you are not, or you're not original enough to be called different from Led Zepp or blah, or this or that, if you're not original enough in sound or whatever, then the minute, you know, Led Zeppelin have a reissue, you're dead in the water. There are lots of different ways of earning income, but the pool of music that all of those advertisers are drawing from is also big, huge, and immediately at their fingertips as well. I think you have to say that actually the music industry is ridiculously closed. Anybody that wants to work hard, if somebody wants to really, really work hard, then what happens is it becomes impossible to keep them out. So, but I think the approach has to be, I'm looking into a goldfish bowl that is absolutely impossible to get into. If that's the start point, and you understand that to be the start point, then I go, okay, now get into it. Now find a way to get into it. Knowing that 90% of people that try and succeed in it are gonna fail, knowing all of those things now, understand that that's your backpack and you know that, right, now add a jetpack to the backpack, right, because that's what you're gonna need in order to cut through. You are gonna need that determination in order to cut through and make yourself, as we say, completely needed within an industry that basically just says, I don't need you. I don't need you. I don't need you. I've already got singers. I've already got this. I've already got A&R people. I've already got MDs. I've already got blah. I've already got blah. I've already got this. I've got everything that I've got it all. Now make yourself indispensable within that industry. And start now.